Welcome. In this tutorial, I will show how to create a new quiz within the Responda software. Once you've downloaded and opened the Responda software on your computer, we'll begin under the Start tab at the top. From here, we'll click Open or Create. To begin with, make sure your current personality is set to D2L Brightspace. D2L Brightspace is the platform which Learn is housed at in the University of Waterloo. To begin, we'll click Create to create a new Responda file. We'll fill in the fields here. To begin, name of file. The name of file should be how you want the quiz on Learn to be viewed as by students. For example, weekly quiz 1. Next, we'll create a description. If you would not like to input a description, simply put the name of file once again. Type of file. There are two types of files. Exam, which is a graded assessment, or survey, which is an ungraded assessment. For this example, we'll do exam, a graded quiz. Click OK. From here, we'll move on to the Edit tab now. You have a variety of question options available to you, such as multiple choice, true or false, long answer, etc. We'll begin by creating an example multiple choice question. We'll start by filling in the fields. Title of question is the title of the question. This is not the question itself. For example, we'll call this question 1. Question wording is the question itself. We'll put an example question here. Next, you'll fill in the answers. From here, you could select the correct answer. In this case, it is B. You could also change the point value. So how much is this answer worth? 1 point, 2 points, 1.5 points, 2.5 points, etc. You could also randomize this or give feedback. Randomizing it will randomize the answers, and giving feedback will allow the student to see the correct answer once they've submitted their answer. This is our first question, so we will add to the end of the list. We can also clear the form, which would reset the form as it looks now. No fields are filled in, or preview the question if we would like. We'll move on to a second example question. We'll do a true or false this time. Again, we'll fill in all fields. Now we can either add to the end of list, which will add it to the bottom of the question list at the bottom of this screen, insert into the list, which will add it to the top, clear form, or preview. If we click preview, we could see how this question will look on Learn. Click OK when you're done. We'll add this to the bottom of the list. We can now see our two questions within the question list at the bottom of the screen. If we click the down arrow beside each of the questions, we can preview, edit, delete, change the order by moving to number, or a variety of other options. Once satisfied that you've added all your questions, you can move on to the Settings tab. Here you can change a variety of settings. To begin, we'll start with Properties. Notification email will allow you to add an email. Once students have submitted their quiz, an email will be sent to that email input here. Disable right clicks, disable pager access, and add an introduction message. The introduction message will appear before the quiz has started. Next, we can move on to restrictions. Here we can change the status, which will allow to be active or inactive, or visible or hidden from students. Add a start and end date, including a time. Make it password protective. Given an IP restriction, this is the case for in-person exams in, say, a computer lab. Change the timing, for example, 10 minutes. We can make that an enforced time. We can show the clock, give a grace period, and allow late submissions. This is only for enforced time limits. We can allow normal submission, although it will be flagged once late. Use a late time limit, so how many minutes after they can submit, or auto submit. So once the time and grace period are up, they will automatically submit the quiz. Next, we'll move on to attempts and submissions. We can allow different number of attempts allowed, from unlimited all the way from 1 through 10. The overall grade calculation, so is the highest, lowest, average, first or last attempt graded. This is only for multiple attempts. If you have one, it doesn't matter what you choose. Default submission view, so once the student has submitted their quiz, what message will they receive? There's a default message here, but you can change this. You could also allow them to see the questions, including correct or incorrect answers. You can change to allow statistics once they've submitted, so such as class average or score distribution as well. You can change the layout, such as how many questions per page, prevent them from moving backwards through pages in the quiz, or change the numbering format. You could also add random sections if you have multiple versions of a quiz and you want students added to multiple sections randomized. Once satisfied with the settings, you can move on to preview and publish. From here, you could preview the quiz. You could see the quiz in its entirety, move through questions, modify items if you wish. Once satisfied, you can click close. From here, we can move to publish. Next, we'll click publish wizard. You can publish to a single course, batch publish to multiple courses, or export a file for manual upload to Brightspace or Learn. Choose your Brightspace server. So I've added Waterloo Learn already. If you have not, add a new server and go through the steps to add Waterloo Learn. Once satisfied, I'm going to publish to a single course. I've added Waterloo Learn as my server. I can click next. Connecting to the server may take several minutes, so please be patient. Once connected to the server, you'll have a few more fields to fill in. First, you'll choose which course to publish to. Here, you can see all the courses you have access to. Select the course you want to publish to from this list. Next, you can create or replace an assessment type. You have the option of a quiz, creating a new quiz or replacing an existing quiz, self-assessment, or question library section. For a quiz, we want to create a new quiz, or we could replace an existing quiz that is already in Learn. We're creating a new quiz, so we've selected that option. The next is three additional options for assessment type. Apply settings and apply random sections are set by default. You can leave those selected. Once satisfied, you've selected the right course and you're creating a new quiz for this example, we can click next. A screen will appear that will show the exporting to Learn. You will get updates as it is exporting. And once complete, it will give you a message saying completed successfully. From here, we can click Finish. We have successfully exported our quiz to Learn. Next, we can go to Learn and view our quiz, clicking Submit and Quizzes. Here we could see our weekly quiz 1, which we just created within Respondus. It has been successfully added to our Learn course. Keep in mind, students will not see this quiz any differently than it had been created within Learn itself. It will look the same and it will be taken the same way as any other quiz. Thank you for watching.